Hi, my name is Jonathan Benhamu. I'm a lecturer at the ETH in Zurich, in Pamplona and in Madrid. And we are right now at the ETH in Zurich. We implement 3D printing as a prototyping tool, as a work in progress tool, as we design buildings in architecture. We encourage our students to build their own 3D printers because that is the best way to ensure that they understand what's mechanically happening. And the better they understand how these machines work, the better they can design accordingly and get the best out of these machines.
Hi, nice to meet you. My name is Birgit Schumann. I'm a first-year architecture student at ETH. So today and yesterday I had my first experience with building a 3D printer from scratch, which was very interesting, also exhausting at the end of the day, but it was a very new learning experience. I'm very excited to see the 3D printer work, actually, yes, and to print the own models that we sketched last week and to actually see them in a 3D form and being able to move them around, look at them from other angles. It is my first experience with 3D printing. We did, of course, see other models already printed around the building, but myself, I've never used a 3D printer before, which is also why I wanted to assemble one all by myself to see exactly how it works with the X and Epsilon and Z axis and how it's constructed.
We use the 3D printers to print everything from contextual models all the way to construction details. This has been the research that I've been leading for the past 5 years to figure out how can we use 3D printing for architectural design. I first became introduced to 3D printer by my wife. She essentially gave the idea that we should have a high-tech architectural office as we were starting up. And while I was confronted with the problem of having little money and a lot to do, to incorporate printing in the classes came after. I essentially developed all these tools and all these workflows and all these ideas for my own firm because I saw the necessity and I saw the potential on how can we do it. Nobody was doing it. I see the possibility of having 3D printers in every architectural domain in the university. One will profit from it more than others. One will profit from specific features, like for example, prototyping for the design part. Others maybe for the quality when it comes to documenting historical buildings. But all in all, I say that since a model is such an intrinsic part of architecture as a branch and as a whole, I see great potential of using 3D printing in every aspect of architecture.
I'm Jonas, I'm 20 years old, I study at ETH in my first year architecture. Actually, I like the week so far, and one of the reasons actually for me to start my architecture studies was that I saw the exhibition last year about the seminar week, and I saw all these different models which were really interesting to me, and I really wondered how it was possible to do all this in 1 week.
My name is Paul, I'm also a first year student at ETH. I've also studied something before, but I was just really intrigued with architecture in general. And knowing also that ETH had a lot of capabilities and tech involvement within the first year, so that was interesting. And for me, it's the first time using 3D printing. I've heard about it, of course, but not much more than this. And I mean, with the team of assistants here, it's been very easy to get into it and very fun as well.
Now at ETH, this is my first time really experiencing the whole thing and learning about the techniques and how this actually works. And it's really great to see how you have this little model on your computer and then you can see how it comes out with the structure. And after all, it looks in the end like a volume, but it's actually a really light structure inside.
It's always a different feeling to hold it in your hands, and it's something that becomes real. And I think for us, at least in terms of first year of architecture students, it's the first thing we built. And it's very rewarding to have it printed.
Prusa printers are really easy to handle, and with the knowledge that we got in our courses, it was quite easy to get started. And also the combination with Prusa slicer makes a nice result.
I think the software is really easy to use and very intuitive. We had minimal introduction, I would say, and by basic tutorials online, it's very easy to understand and to get through setup and everything. So it was very nice to have that of a simple and easy to use software to get in.
In my particular program at the ETH, we were confronted with a challenge. We had the means to get enough printers, but we didn't have the means to pay for the manpower that it would take to take care of those printers. So we decided to include the students in it, making it so that at the end, every printer we have was built by the students, getting the added value that now they know how they work so they can fix it themselves. So after 5 years, what we do is that we sell 20 printers at the end of each year to the students at a reduced price. We get 20 new printers. Those get built by the new students of the year after, and we constantly have an up-to-date lab.
Hello, my name is William Scheppi and I am from the high-tech team here at the University ETH Zurich. In the high-tech team, I'm supporting not only the students, but also our members from the high-tech team. I am organizing everything, and also I am looking that we have all the materials here at the ETH from Prusa. I'm also supporting students, helping them with their printers, and if they have problems with the printers, like it's not printing or they have a broken part, then I fix it with them together. Right now, we are standing in the 3D lab. We were planning this for a long time because our first 3D printing lab was just a shipment container. Like, we had this container filled with 88 printers. However, there were problems because it heated up to 60 degrees and also the air was not good. So we figured out a system with this room here, and also there's next to this room another room where we have just only ventilation. Right now we are standing in the ASL, and on each side we have glass doors that are closing the printers. In this cavity, the air is flowing. All the particles that are inside the air from the printer are removed. Also, you have here some ventilation that puts air down, so the students have always fresh air around. The students love the opportunity that they can 3D print at the university, especially because it's a way that they can express their ideas much faster than just with a cardboard model. Also, they do not have to build a model by hand. They can just let the machine print and think about their concept. I couldn't imagine my life without 3D printing, especially in the architectural field, because it's much better, you are much faster, and you can actually also recycle your models now, and you're not producing so much trash. We decided to buy Prusa printers because they are the easiest to maintain. You can easily reprint your parts, you can disassemble it very quick, and you can replace the parts. And also you have a very good documentation online.
What I like most about Prusa printers is the community. I think that the support and the way and the spirit it all comes together is absolutely fantastic. I encourage my students to get involved and ask their questions straight to Google, just adding the word Prusa at the end, and then they'll probably get an excellent answer from someone out there in the world. The students absolutely love it. First, they get very excited about the idea that they're going to learn how to 3D print. And then they keep getting impressed and more impressed of how much can it be used for. I can't imagine a world today without 3D printing anymore. It just wouldn't work, because now we're constantly upping the value of the man hour, and anything that will reduce or give a task to a machine is going to be necessary. It's absolutely necessary. And I think it is the task of each professional to figure out how can that be implemented as such to further the value of human intelligence.